Welcome to the video today, guys. Today I'm going to be doing the Disney and Pixar bracket. So basically, one side of this bracket is going to be only Disney movies. Now they're not all here. These are all animated, by the way. A selected few that I saw this and really wanted to do it. And on the other side, we're gonna have some Pixar movies, and this is a little outdated, so there's a Toy Story 4, Toy Story 4, Onward yet, but this is still pretty up to date, good enough. Coco's on here, so yeah, let's go on to the first one. I'm gonna have a nice view of the paper here. So the first matchup is the Lion King, and Tarzan. Now I think this is a very good matchup because number one, they're both really good movies, but there's like a couple of problems that I have with The Lion King. Not that it's a bad movie, but like when comparing it to Tarzan, I really just see Tarzan coming on top. Like there's some scenes where I feel it's a little unnecessary. The Lion King, some scenes are too long. I feel like Tarzan is gonna have to take the lead on this one. All right, let's move on to The Princess and Frog and Lilo and Stitch. Now, Princess and Frog is good, but I personally don't feel like it's anything special that has Disney done. It's a classic story, but watching a full-length movie about it really, I feel, is a little bit unnecessary and not needed. So, and Lilo and Stitch is a really good film, and it addresses some problems like that families can truly have, and I think Lilo is gonna have to take that one. Alright, moving on to Tangled and Big Hero 6. Well, first time I watched Big Hero 6, I really enjoyed it, but as time went on, I feel like, I don't know, it wasn't that great. It was a cool movie, but I'm not a big superhero movie guy, so that could be some of the issue. No, I'm gonna go for Big Hero 6. Tier 6 is underrated. All right. Frozen and Moana. So they're both none of my really great favorites at all. I don't really like either, but they are good movies. But they're just not my taste. So I'm probably gonna have to do Frozen because I probably laugh more in Frozen than I did in Moana, even though Moana was, I think, it was a very beautiful movie. Like, where the location was, but I wasn't entertained. Aladdin, Hercules. You know me, I'm a big Aladdin fan, and I think Aladdin wins this by a lot. Hercules is okay. I'm not a big favorite. I mean, just Robin Williams really makes that movie there, and I feel like his performance in that is amazing and should really deserve to move on. Okay, The Little Mermaid and Pocahontas. Well, I'm gonna be honest with you. I feel like I'm gonna lose a lot of people here on my bracket. By the way, if you guys wanna do this bracket, you could find it easily anywhere you'd like. But type in Disney Pixar bracket and it will be one of the first ones. I'm gonna go Pocahontas here. Because I love the idea of the nature and like the theme. Native Americans in film are very rare. They were more common in earlier film, but not very common now. So I'm glad there was a thing like that, and I feel like they did it really well against something like that. Right, now here's gonna be a matchup that is gonna really play with my life here. We have Mulan and Zootopia. Now these are both very much movies I really like. Zootopia, I had really hype for it, but in the trailers, they didn't really show at all what was really gonna happen in the movie.
I think they did an amazing job with the trailers. I knew that it was gonna be like a crime sort of movie, but they really, really did it well, and I really feel like it's up there. But Mulan has such a great story, and I feel like it's very authentic and original. Like there isn't much I feel like it's one of the only Chinese cultured movies
that are cartoons that take it a different way. But I feel like, sorry, Mulan, but Zootopia is gonna have to take the lead on this one. Speaking of another hard matchup here, we have Beauty and the Beast and Nightmare Before Christmas. I'm gonna have to do Beauty and the Beast. I'm gonna do B&B because it's a little long. But Nightmare Before Christmas is too, but it just, I don't get a good feeling watching it, if that makes any sense. I just wish there was a little more to it. All right, let's jump over to the Pixar side here. We've got Up and Brave. Now, kind of a little bit of a Big Hero 6 thing going on here. I liked Brave in the beginning, but the more I watch it, I don't. I feel like I'm gonna have to go Up on this one. Up has a very good story, and I really like the characters, and it's very original. Toy Story or Toy Story 2? Do we even have to talk about this one? Toy Story 2, in my opinion, wasn't anything special. Is that Cars 2? Yeah, okay. Coco or Cars 2? Coco for sure. I didn't think Cars 2 was anything special. I don't get why they, like, Cars 3 was still better, but I don't feel like there needed to be another one just because it did well. Like, I don't know, it feels like it unnecessary. Toy Story 3 of the Good Dinosaur. Toy Story 3, I wasn't a big fan of the Good Dinosaur. I thought it looked really realistic, and I liked the idea, but there wasn't much characters in it. There wasn't much dialogue. It wasn't really a funny movie, and I understand what they were trying to do, but that's not
Really, what I want to watch when I see Pixar, I want to see like a variety of characters with different personalities contrasting with in a situation, and there's just obviously humor involved, and there wasn't much of that. Ratatouille or A Bug's Life.
I'm gonna have to do Ratatouille. Because A Bug's Life.
I love Ratatouille, and I feel like I've talked about it before, but A Bug's Life, I feel like, is a good story, but I don't know, I wish there was more in the characters. Like, it was hard to differentiate them, in my opinion, because they all look very similar. Like, I wish they just had, like, them different colors at least. I feel like that would have really helped me a lot.
Finding Nemo Inside Out. Finding Nemo for sure. Finding Nemo might win this. I don't know. I mean, I can't predict the future, but Finding Nemo would destroy anything. Inside Out is really good, but I've got a couple of problems with it.
I feel like it's more of a better concept than it is an actual thing. So that's something like a movie, but yeah. Monsters, Inc. versus Cars.
Monsters, Inc. for sure. Cars, I think Monsters, Inc. is really good.
And Monsters University might be better than Monsters, Inc. I don't know, but it's really amazing, and I just love the characters, and it just has such a great, it's a brand new world, and it's done so well. Incredibles or Wall-E? I'm gonna have to give it to the Increds. Wall-E is good. Once again, a better idea than what it is. It's a pretty rough movie to watch through, entertainment-wise, because there just isn't much content to really entertain yourself with.
All right, we're jumping back over to the Disney side. We're gonna have to pace things a little quicker here, but obviously it's gonna get a lot easier now. But Tarzan and Lilo and Stitch. So this is a tough one. It's funny because Tarzan is my brother's favorite out of all these, I think. And his wife, Kate, his wife's favorite movie is Lilo and Stitch. So this is a battle right here. It's just funny. But Tarzan's gonna have to come on top on this one. Lilo and Stitch is good, but it's not that good of the level of Tarzan. I know Tarzan isn't 100% original, but the characters are. I feel like the personalities, you see any other Tarzan, it's just not good. Especially the newest one. I just feel like Tarzan, that one is really good. Alright, Big Hero 6, Frozen. Not gonna lie, doesn't really matter, because they're right here. Any of these two isn't beating Tarzan. So, you know, let's just get Big Hero 6 up there, because I think it would win it. This matchup, but no way it is beating Tarzan. Alright, Aladdin versus Pocahontas. Once again, I
just feel like Aladdin's really gotta win that one. I feel like it explained why, and just it just overpowers Pocahontas. Zootopia versus Beauty and the Beast. This is a tough one. So, I think I'm gonna have to say Zootopia.
Simply just because I think the characters in it are very original, and it gets pretty deep if you look at like kind of the themes. And Beauty and the Beast is a classic, and I respect it for a lot of reasons, but I feel like I wish there was more with like the clock in the air in Cogsworth, and that's kind of it. I don't know. That was a very close one. Seems right now the Disney side is really struggling. Let's get on back to the Pixar side. We've got Up versus Toy Story. Toy Story is going to have to take this one as well. I really like Up, but
I've got some problems with it because it's just a little wild. Like, it's a little weird. And just like the dogs on the planes, it's very weird. It gets really out of control, I feel. But it gets the message done, and it does it in a fun way. But I really feel like it's just a little wild. It's not tamed at the end. But Toy Story is Toy Story. And I feel like that's enough.
Coco versus Toy Story 3. Toy Story 3. Oh gosh, we're gonna have a Toy Story clash down. Coco. I feel like I give it some respect because it hasn't been done before. That Mexican culture is really something that was really entertaining for me, because I personally don't know barely anything about that, but I was really glad that it was done, people could be, get an experience of that, or people get to immerse it or see that perspective of the world. Ratatouille versus Finding Nemo. This is an extremely tough one, and I don't want to give Ratatouille disrespect because I'm doing it quickly. It truly is a hard one, but Finding Nemo is gonna have to take the dub here.
I told you that it's gonna obliterate the competitors, but it's just that good. It's really that good. I can't. It's literally just it's could be the best. I think it might be the best animated film of all time, and the story is so well done. So many variety of characters, bringing the ocean never done before. They owned no other ocean animated film. It's always going to be compared to Finding Nemo. It's never going to win. Never. All right. Monsters, Inc. versus Incredibles.
Going to be honest with you, I don't really like Incredibles. I thought Incredibles 2 was much better, for sure. Incredibles 2 was on here. I still don't think it would be in Monsters, Inc., but it would definitely be a debate for sure, because I think Monsters, Inc. was really well done, especially making a sequel. I feel like you gotta give it some break for that, and I think that it's worth noting that you have to continue with this world and at least be on the level of especially something that is so good. All right, we're back to the Disney side. We only have a couple of more matchups left, so let's get into it. Tarzan versus Big Hero 6. I already said it. I'm sorry. Tarzan wins. I feel like I should explain why. Tarzan is so good because of its characters, the monkeys. I mean, what else do you want to say? Monkeys, apes, gorillas. What else more do you need? He kills a leopard. I mean, I feel like. All right, Aladdin versus Zootopia. All right, this little batch around here, this has been a tough one. Hercules and Little Mermaid, not really, but this has really been an area where it's really caused me a lot of pain and deciding over one thing over another, and it's really been a challenge, but Aladdin versus Zootopia. Now, I feel like Zootopia has to win this one. The only reason why I'm debating it is because the whole Try Everything song is just really unnecessary. It's really long. I personally
dislike it very much, and it shows up so many times, and I get what they're trying to do, but it's just, I don't like it. I really don't like the song. It bothers me now. I feel like I'm scarred for life from it, but you know what? It still beats Aladdin.
I feel like Aladdin made it pretty far.
Fun fact, I only watched Aladdin very recently for the first time, like in the past year. So the fact that it's got this far, I feel like, honestly, it deserves some respect for that, because it's on the newer side for me, and making it that far is pretty cool in my opinion. Toy Story versus Toy Story 3. We're back on the Pixar side. Now, here's the thing. This could be one of the hardest, because All right. Here's the deal. Alright, I decided.
Toy Story, and simply just because of Sid. I think the character of Sid is really good. I'm gonna say that's his name. I think he's really well done in that, and I like that part of it. It really immerses you in the Toy Story world, and I think that's why I beat Toy Story 3. I think the ending of Toy Story 3 is like trying to be too much of an end of the long cut series and takes away from it. Finding Nemo, Monsters Inc. Honestly, two amazing movies, but Finding Nemo is gonna have to take this one. I think the story of Finding Nemo
is stronger and more impactful for a lot of people, and the characters have very different personalities. You really feel the story, and the story just connects to you. Alright, this is it. This is the end of it here. We're at the end stretch. We're in the semifinals. We have Tarzan versus Zootopia. We got two animal, mostly animal-themed movies here, and Tarzan
is gonna slay the beast. Zootopia is really good. I feel like I've talked a lot about Zootopia and Tarzan, so I feel like I've talked about these movies enough. I've explained my reasoning, so let's just kind of just move through. Tarzan, I feel like, wins by, compared to what was going on down here, pretty large gap, so I don't feel like that was much of a tough one, but it's a shame Zootopia couldn't make it to the final. Toy Story Finding Nemo, once again, tough to go through here. But
Finding Nemo is really gonna have to take this one. Once again, the story, I just need to check.
Now we're here. The big final. The final. And it's a pretty big deal because if you guys have watched my if you watch my ranking every Disney and Pixar movie, you'll see who, if I'm sure these both were on the same tier at the top. So let's see which one is truly better, and in my opinion. And I'm going to have
to hit you with Finding Nemo. They're both very close, I think. Once again, it has that same idea of variety of characters with all different personalities going through it. But I think the impact that Pixar has with the music and everything truly
is something special. I think that song, when Marlin thinks of Nemo in that song and you hear it at key points in the movie, really just gives you goosebumps. And I really feel like that's what makes it, and that's what Pixar is best at, and that's why it beats Tarzan, because you have that really strong emotion and you feel like you can connect to the story. Alright, so that is my bracket. If you guys want to do this bracket, please look up Disney Pixar bracket and you can fill it out yourself. Please let me know if you agree or disagree with what I have here, because this is really fun. I'm going to see if there's any more of these, because I know you guys like me talking about DreamWorks, Pixar, the animation films, and I'd love to do it, because I've watched them all and I'm really interested to see what you guys think of this. So thank you guys for watching the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.